what it means, for example, to love someone else. And this you've really experienced, the love of God yourself. And this, where does this happen? Not only in that place where you meet with God, but where you're outside. In Elisa's life, how can she understand or appropriate the love of God unless she receives it? Whether it be in the form of other people around her. When I pick her up sometimes, just to help her to do the things that a human being needs to do, when I pick her up off the chair, she says, "Don't you get tired of it?" I say, "No, you know what? Doing this is saving us both. It's giving me an opportunity to experience the power of God, how much He loves you. And you an opportunity to actually allow Him to pick you up. Because He picks you up and says, 'My child.' It's separate, it's bigger than both of you and me and our relationship. It's got nothing to do with me, that no one's more important here." So there it is. I want to encourage you to go to that place inside of your heart where you say, "Lord Jesus, I'm here." And sometimes you might find that you may not experience His peace. And it's not that He's not there. He's busy pointing at an issue in your heart. And listen to Him. "I need you to give that up. I need you to surrender that to me. I need you to empty. I want to come into your heart, but there's some things that I want to show you about yourself.